Hello, welcome to everyone in this video. This is our lecture number 44. Already 43 are lectures covered to solve the problem of this book, that is Electricity and Magnetism by Vasudev Ghosh. This is part 25 of this book, that is 24 part of this book actually covered the chapter 1 to chapter 6 and then chapter 7 question 1 to question 20 over already covered. Okay. So if you want to watch, then link even in the description box, you can go through the description box. And the other lecture consists to the solution of the DJ Griffith book, solution of the problem in this asked in the DJ Griffith electrodynamics, right? So let's start with question number 21 to question number 30. We want to discuss chapter 8, that is the magnetism. Actually magnetism consists of this chapter, that is the magnetism. So magnetostatics, actually the chapter name is magnetostatics. So we will start to do, that's the problem, question number 21 to 30. I want to say to sorry to all of you, that's there is a discontinuity to provided the solution of this series, because there was my PhD viva section, already you know that about these things. We link in the last video actually consists about all these things. So let's start with the solution of this question number 21 to 30 of this video, right? So question number 21 says, that is the a wire carrying a current I, right, bent in the form of equilateral triangle. This is a equilateral triangle of side A. It is placed in a uniform magnetic field B. Its plane parallel to the direction of the magnetic field. So if you take the magnetic field perpendicular to this plane, then its plane and the magnetic field is the parallel to each other. So calculate the torque acting on the magnetic field. Torque on the acting on the magnetic field is the nothing but the magnetic moment cross B, and magnetic moment is nothing but I into A. And what is the value of area is root 3 by 4 a square. So the torque will be in the magnitude, this, since these are the perpendicular to each other, this is a parallel, so cos sine sine 0 is 1. So the magnitude will be like that, that is the root 3 a y, and what is the value of b. So this is the answer, I think, clear. Go to the next one. Next one says, is slightly ionized atom, slightly ionized atom enter a region between two parallel metal plate with a velocity v. So this is a metal plate and this is a slightly ionized atom is entered within this metallic plate. The separation between the plate are d and potential difference is v. So this potential difference is b. Find the magnitude force required to keep the ion magnet undeflected between the plate. So you can see there is a electric field here, and the electric field is like that, v by d. So the ionized charge atom q, then the force, electric force will be qe, so that is q v by d. And if we apply magnetic field b, then the force on the charge due to magnetic field will be q v b. So if we want to say that these are the undeflected, that means this magnetic force and the electric field will be the equal. So this must be to equal to each other. So from here we will be get the value of magnetic field by which we can be undeflected this the velocity of this particle. Go to the next one. An infinitely long wire carrying current I ampere is bent into L shape. So L shape in XY plane, find the magnetic field at this point 2,2 with respect to the bending point at the origin, assuming that the current flow in the direction negative x axis and the positive y axis. For this angle is 90 for infinity, and this is nothing but 45 degree, because this is 2 and this is 2, this is 45 degree. So if you just put this value in this equation, you will be get this thing. Okay, and from here you can see here this is in the inward, that's meant into the page, that's mean the minus k cap. Similarly for this direction, this is for the 90 degree and this is for the 45 degree. So finally you get this thing and the answer will be like that. But I think this is an error, because you can see here that is for the, this is for the -45 degree. I think the actual wall will be, this is -45 degree, and this gives you the minus. This gives you minus, so this gives you minus. So finally you will get, if you added these two things, that is gives you 2 root 2, and this added gives you 2 root 2 by 2. So these two cancel out, so this will be like, sorry, this is if you added this to 1, so 2 root 2, these 2 root 2 root 2 cancel out, so these two are cancel out. So finally you will be get this answer, that is 4 pi k cap. This is I think so, if we actually taking this account, but the book answer is written here. Okay, so written here, but I think this will be the this answer, right? Go to the next one. A long straight wire is carrying current 2.5 ampere in the z direction, right? Find the magnetic field B at this point 3, 4, 5. So if you take this point 3, 4, 5, then what will be the distance from z direction? This is root over 3 square plus 4 square, that is 5. So the magnetic field at the direction at a certain distance, you know, mu 0 by 4 pi 2i by r. Mu 0 by 4 pi is 10 to the minus 7, 2i is 2.5 and r is 5, so this will be 10 to the minus 7 tesla. Next question. A current distribution gives rise the magnetic vector potential. This is the magnetic vector potential. Find the corresponding magnetic field. You know the magnetic vector potential related to the magnetic field, that is B equals to curl of A. So just curl of this vector in this cylindrical coordinate system. So in the cylindrical coordinate system, you know this is the curl. So just put this value of this A value, that is only z direction. So we will take this del del r, we will del del theta, when take this r cap, so del del theta of this, and when take this r theta cap, then del del r of this. So final answer will be like that. Clear? Next question. So that the magnetic scalar potential phi due to the circular loop of radius A carrying current I at an axial point at a distance x from the center will be like that. So you know from the previous discussion that is magnetic field at the distance x from the loop of a radius A is nothing but like that. Now the potential that is phi related to magnetic field will be like that, scalar potential. So phi can be find out by integrating this B only x direction, this variable is x. So with integration with respect to x, the phi value will be like that. You will take the x equal to a tan theta, the integration can be simplified like that. You will take this x equal to tan theta, so dx equal to a s x square theta d theta. Just put this value, you will be get this integrated value. Now the constant can be obtained by this condition, that is x at x equals to infinity. When x equal to infinity, the magnetic field will be 0. Putting this condition, you will be get the value of c equals to I by 2. So the final answer will be I by 2. The final answer will be like that. So this magnetic field will be like the phi will be like that. So I think there is error in the written, that is not B, this is phi, this is not B, phi is 0, B is 0, that means the phi is 0. So this is phi, I just right, so this will be the phi. Clear? Next question. Find the magnetic field B near a long straight conducting current I. Hence, so by direct calculation, divergent B is 0. So for a long current conductor, you know the magnetic field will be like that, mu 0 I by 2 pi r theta cap, using the Ampere's circuital law. So curl of divergence of B, just put this value of this divergence in the cylindrical coordinate system, because this is a theta cap, so you will be get this will be 0 because there is no function of theta, right? Next question. Consider a long non-magnetic hollow cylindrical carrying a current I. The inner and outer radii of the cylinder are A and B respectively. Assuming the current density to be uniform, find the magnetic field as a function of radial distance. So when R less than A, you need to find out the magnetic field at this three region. So when R less than A, that is inside the hollow sphere, there will be no current. If you take this sphere, that is the will be take like that within the r equals to a. So there is no current density within that. So the current density will be current is zero. So the magnetic field also zero within that region, that is inside the hollow space. When this region between a to b, then we will need to take a circular loop. So this is 2 pi r and this will be j da. J is the current density, is nothing but the current per area, right? So the current density is uniform, so this will be like that into area is pi r square minus a square. This will be that area. This is the side view and this is the top view. So from top view you can see this is radius a and this is b. So we take the radius r, which is line between a to b. So you need to dig this area, and this is nothing but pi r square minus pi a square, that is pi r square minus a square, but the total will be pi r square b square minus a square. So finally you get the magnetic field will be like that. Next one is when r greater than b, the so for r greater than b is total current will be I. So from where will be get the magnetic field, total magnetic field r greater than b. Go to the next one, that is say suppose the earth magnetic field is caused by a small current loop located the center of the earth. This is the center of the earth, there is a small current loop. The axis of the loop coincide with the axis of rotation. This is the axis of rotation and this axis is coincide. If the magnetic field of pole is B0, here the magnetic field is B0. The radius of the earth is R, that the magnetic moment of the loop, the magnetic moment of the loop will be like that. So from the previous discussion, we know for a current carrying loop, the magnetic field will be distance X will be like that. So the B0 will be like that because X is very much greater than A. That means this distance is very much greater than X is nothing but RQ. So from here, we will be get the current within this loop. And you know the magnetic moment is nothing but I into A. I is the current, A is the area. So I is replaced by this and area is pi A square. Just putting this value will be get this answer, very simple, where A is taken the radius of this loop. Next question, a magnetic dipole B m equals to m j cap, m is a value and j cap is the unit vector placed in the magnetic field like that. So this is the magnetic field and this is the dipole moment. So find the force on this dipole. So find the force on the dipole is nothing but m dot divergence into b. So just this is a Cartesian coordinate system, so this is nothing but only j cap. So this curl actually you know very well, this is nothing but I cap del del x, j cap del del y and k cap del del z. So when we dot this m, there is j only, so you will be get del del y. So if you just derivative with respect to y, you will be get this answer. I think clear all about the, if there is any doubt you must comment in the comment box, right? So that's it for me. This is all about me and this is my contact details and this is my YouTube channel details. Go to this channel, you will be get the others video like different part of this physics, and like this session. If you benefit from this video, share this video to your friends so that she or he also get benefit from this video. Subscribe this channel if you new in this channel. Those already subscribe, thanks for subscription. Press the bell icon to get the notification of upcoming video. So take care, we will meet in the next video as soon as possible. Thanks for watching and we will meet into the next portion of this series of this book. So take care all of you. We will be meeting in the next video as soon as possible. Thank you.